Today I want to share a very special Qigong system with you guys. It's a secret Qigong that I never taught before. It's coming from the Grandmaster Zhang Xuniao. And I will, in this tutorial, step by step guide you through it. You can, if you want, directly also follow the video, yeah, and practice with me this Qigong. So, first you should start in a standing position, as we always do in our Qigong. Yeah. Wuji Zhuang is a good posture to start with. But here it's important, don't stand too long before the Qigong, that you keep the standing pretty short. Yeah, maybe one breath circle or two is almost already too much. Yeah, so after you stand very short in Wuji Zhuang, you start with the first exercise by lifting the arms to the side. And when you lift the arms, take care that you first of all lift and tension your shoulders. Yeah, that's very important here for this exercise. I bring the arms up and I bring it really from tensioning the shoulders and pulling the shoulders up to my ears. It's the first step. The second step is, now I bring my jaw forward and backward with the releasing of the arms. Yeah, I really try to curve my neck, feel some tension in the neck, disconnect the neck from the rest of the body. Shoulders go up and chin forward. Then we add the lower back. Lower back is now in the same moment curving. Yeah, so we try not to relax the lower back, but really like to pull it towards the belly and tension it while we lift the arms. Yeah, so the lifting of the arms is even like we support it by curving the lower back. From here you go to the next step, and while you curve the lower back, you let the knees drop to the middle. Okay, knees drop to the middle and back out. Knees drop to the middle, curve the lower back, tension the shoulders, very important, yeah, and then go back. From here, you start now to breathe. And you try really not to breathe naturally and soft, but you really push the breath in, like you press the breath in, force it in, and then also press it out again pretty forcefully. Yeah? So you're really not breathing natural, but you try to really find an unnatural breath. It's also very good if it's unrhythmic and you make maybe noises while you breathe. Okay, so this is the first exercise. It's called the flying duck. For the pillar of the standing duck, you also stand in the same position as we had before. Shoulders go up by lifting the arms. The chin goes forward and my lower back is tensioning, my knees collapse to the middle. I really feel some pressure on the inside meniscus and my hip joints are quite tense. Yeah? So I really try in this posture now, I stand and I try really to feel this disconnection of heaven on earth. So I really try to carry gravity with my muscles. Yeah, I'm really trying not to use the structure of the body, but to fight against the gravity. It's very important in this exercise. When you feel like slowly, like maybe your muscles create some pain, you try to increase the pain by breathing nervous. and worrying about the pain even more. Like you really try to focus on the pain and get stressed and afraid that it's really strong, the pain, and getting more and more. Okay, this is the standing exercise, and for this you stand like for 5 minutes. And now I lift my leg and I step forward, yeah. And here it's important that I'm not stepping controlled, but I really fall with my weight into the steps. Yeah, very important. So it's very uncontrolled step work, and you still have this lifting of the shoulders. You still have like this tensing of the lower back, like very nervous feeling while you do it. And trying really to use, like, or being really disconnected from your center motion. So that everything really is moving by itself and the center is not at all supporting your movement. So this was the 3 exercises. Of the secret Qigong. It's called the Flying Duck Qigong, and it has its origin in also a story, a legend, because as you all know, we have this very strong Qigong, Hui Chun Qigong, that with the practice we try to refill our energies and come back to our own spring, becoming more young. So in the Wudang Mountains, they practiced this for very long and very intense, and at a certain point they got too young, and got too old. So they were thinking, okay, how can we balance this again? And there this flying duck Qigong was invented, that like observed, okay, how can I now go back to a bit less healthy movement, like really bringing more tension into my body in order to balance this healthy lifestyle again with a bit unhealthy movement, and decreasing the energy again, so that you also still can age and get older and have a good balanced life, to not be too healthy through the Qigong that we are doing. And get the shoulders up.